We are going to begin our discussion of the periodic table by defining a few terms that we need. The first is the element, and the periodic table is the periodic table of elements. And elements are the simplest type of matter. These are the simplest type that have unique chemical and physical properties. Okay, and an element refers to one type of atom. So an element may be represented by a one or two letter symbol. If it's a one letter symbol, it's a simple capital letter, like F for fluorine or N for nitrogen. And the other case is they may be represented by two letters where there's one capital and one small case letter, such as AU for gold or CO for cobalt. All right, then a molecule is two or more of these atoms bonded together. So a molecule may be two or more atoms that are the same, such as hydrogen bonded to a hydrogen, or H2. Or they may be different, such as hydrogen bonded to an oxygen bonded to another hydrogen, which is H2O. A compound, then, is different because it only comprises two or more atoms that are bonded to each other but contain at least two different atoms. So in other words, H2O is also a compound, but H2 is not, because there are not two different atoms. And finally, a mixture is simply a commingling of two or more elements or compounds, and there's no bonding between them whatsoever. All right, then, on to the periodic table. The periodic table is organized into periods and groups. Periods are the rows of elements, and groups are the columns. Okay, so then in terms of groups, we have the A groups. Notice A's are all the A groups are in blue in this diagram, and those are known as the main group elements. On some periodic tables, they're simply numbered 1 through 18 for the groups, but the A and B designation is useful to remember which ones are main group and which ones are transition elements, which is the other group, other set of groups. Okay, so the other elements on this picture shown in yellow and green are the transition elements. Okay, and those transition elements include the lanthanides and actinides, which are usually shown below the rest of the periodic table. All right, then there are a few groups that you need to know the names of specifically, and those are the first two groups and the last two groups. The first group is known as the alkali metals, except for the first one, which I'll talk about in just a minute. And the second group is known as alkaline earth metals. And then we also need to know the names of the last two. The very last group is the noble gases. And the second to last group is the halogens. Okay, here is the periodic table in all of its glory and showing the one or two element symbols for each element. Each box is one element. And here is the element that was from the last slide that is not an alkali metal. It is actually a nonmetal, which is what I'm going to talk about in this slide, metals and nonmetals. So those elements that are shown in this sort of turquoisey blue here are, other than hydrogen, are the metals. And all metals have certain properties in common. They are shiny. Most all of them are solids at room temperature. The exception is mercury. And they also conduct electricity and heat very well. Okay, this is in contrast to the nonmetals, which are shown in pink, and actually do include hydrogen. Hydrogen belongs with the nonmetals. Okay, so the nonmetals are the ones in pink, and those have properties opposite of the metals in general. They are not shiny. They're dull or brittle. They don't conduct well. So they have very different properties. And they also tend to bond very differently, which we will talk about later. In between the two, and along this zigzag line going down the periodic table, are the elements known as metalloids. They are sometimes referred to as semi-metals. And they simply have properties that are in between those of the metals and the non-metals. So we put them in between, and sometimes they bond like a metal, sometimes like a non-metal, so they are in between. All right, and then as far as bonding, the metals will form compounds by losing an electron. So they lose electrons. The nonmetals will form compounds by either gaining an electron, one or more electron, so electrons, or sharing electrons. And again, the metalloids will do something in between. All right, then to summarize the terms you need to know related to the periodic table, you need to know which elements are metals, which elements are nonmetals, and which elements are metalloids by looking at the periodic table. You also need to know which are main group elements, okay, the A's, which are transition elements, which are the B's. And then you need to know a few specific groups. The alkali metals, 1A, alkaline earth metals, 2A, halogens 7A, and noble gases 8A. We can also talk about how those specific groups gain, lose, or share electrons in order to form compounds. The alkali metals, as in all metals, will lose an electron, but they lose one electron to form compounds. The alkaline earth metals lose two electrons. The halogens are in nonmetals, and they gain electrons to form compounds, or share electrons. And the noble gases often don't form compounds. They're actually very stable all by themselves without gaining or losing or sharing electrons, although they do occasionally. All right, so this summarizes our introduction to the periodic table, and we will certainly talk about the periodic table in more depth later in the course.